Okay, it's been a while since I've done a napping video. I have been breaking a lot of rock and trying some abo techniques, and I've learned something very valuable. Abo is a pain in the butt. No kidding. Anyway, I'm gonna just get out some frustration and do a napping video and get back in the swing of things. This is a heat-treated rock. It was actually a lot lighter than this one before I cooked it. So a light-colored stone works pretty good. The darker stuff tends to break up. And I'll make another video on my observations on heat treating a little bit later. Anyway, this is not heated all the way to 500 degrees. I think I heated this one up to about 350. And it's a little bit tougher than usual. It's not going to be a bird point this time. And I'm wearing my gloves, or one glove. I cut the fingertips off because the indirect percussion tool was ripping the tips anyway. And it's also cooler. It's very hot out here. Anyway. Change the camera angle a little bit to give you a little bit of a closer view, or not closer, but more of a view that I have. The camera is in my field of vision right now. A little bit. It's not too bad, but I think this is about the closest I can get the camera to my eyes that I can. Now I'm going to try to explain a little bit as I go. I roughed this out with a hammer stone first, about this size here. I love this size, but it on cooked stone or heat treated rock, it tends to hit way too hard, so I use a smaller one. It's a lot safer. Now what I could do is I could use the hammer stone against this edge here and remove a lot of this mass, but I'm not going to. I'm going to use the indirect percussion tool. I'm getting a little bit better at using the hammer stone, but I still like it just for basic shaping. And I've been trying to figure out what angles work best, and on the stone, and as far as the relationship between the stone and the percussion tool. And I can't narrow it down to any specific angle. The angles vary quite a bit. It also depends on what kind of platform I'm building. The angle is something that you get used to over time. I tried to figure out exactly what I'm doing, and it's very, very difficult, believe it or not. The energy and the forces are different with percussion than with pressure. It looks like I can be a lot more sloppy with the percussion tool and not prepare my platforms very well. And just kind of haphazardly go at it. Pressure requires more of a systematic approach, I think. Maybe that's why I'm not good at it. But I don't prepare the edge very much. And sometimes I don't use the hammer stone to prepare the edge. Sometimes I use the tool itself, and I kind of scratch the edge to make it dull. And this actually works pretty good. It's a little bit awkward, but it works really good to remove any weak spots on the edge. Just kind of scratch it back like this. And the angle that you get when you, on the stone, when you get down to making your platforms, the angle you get when you're scratching back like this is perfect. You just set your tool right in that recess that you just created. Right in there, the rounded end of it, in that little recess. And that can drive a flake pretty far. The angle, I tend to get a little bit too aggressive because I don't like short flakes. And that ends up stepping a lot of times, but after a while you just get used to what you can get away with. See, I was a little bit too aggressive there, so it didn't go very far. It just kind of stepped. So I back off a little bit on the next one. It looks like I might have to build up platforms that are stronger than this. So I am getting a lot of steps. Took off a short flake. But if I think about it too much, a lot of times I don't really have much success. If I just stop thinking about it and go to town, I can usually thin it out without much problem. And that's just due to experience. I can't really tell you guys how to make that happen exactly. It's just experience. I know when an edge looks really weak by experience. I don't really understand why it is that I do what I do down to precise scientific terms or anything. I just know that if I want to drive a flake into this mass here, I've got to have a pretty strong platform. And if I want to do that quickly, I just brush with a hammer stone. You don't hit directly onto it, you brush the edge. And you try not to get steps on this other side. Which means you're brushing at a fairly tame angle. You're not really being aggressive with it. You're just barely brushing. And it's rough. It catches the edges. And of course, a braiding makes it even stronger. So what I'm going to do is I'll cut it short here in a minute, but I'm just going to take this one flake and see how well it does. I hit that pretty hard and it broke up, but it took off what I wanted to. And it sets me up for the next flake coming in through here.